Hey guys, did you remember that we published a teardown video of Apple 143 watts power adapter of the all-new 24-inch iMac? If you haven't seen it, you can click the upper right corner to check it out. Many audiences left comments below and requested us to check what's inside of that cable as well. So, here it comes. Just as we mentioned in the previous video, this adapter has an Ethernet port. So the interference will be a big problem technically. Let's see how Apple handles it. Firstly, the wide sleeve can protect the junction. The woven cable is pretty thick and durable. The connector is a blue cylinder and integrates magnets. There are 12 contacts inside. It adjusts automatically without the need for precise alignment. And the cable length is about 2 meters. After taking it apart, we can see the Ethernet port is in here. The Ethernet cable is fixed in the gap by glue and connects to the junction. The network transformer and filter inductor are next to the Ethernet port. The junction is protected by glue. The Ethernet port is covered with a metal plate for shielding and reinforcement. Let's take a close look at the Ethernet port. The red wires are used for charging and the color wires are Ethernet cable. Cut off the cable and there are many wires inside, just like other cables. There is a layer of TPE under the woven mesh. Remove the TPE layer. The shielding layer is also braided. And a layer of aluminum foil can reduce the interference. Those wires are helically wound, which can improve the tensile performance, and is very similar to the rainbow Apple Watch bands. I'm not sure if it corresponds to the different colors of the brand new iMac. Let's separate the wires and introduce them one by one. Those 8 red wires are connected to positive, and those 4 bare-tinned copper wires and the shielding are connected to negative. Except for the positive and negative wires we just mentioned, the remaining 8 colored wires are all part of the Ethernet cable used for network or data transmission. In order to improve the anti-interference performance, its structure is more complicated than regular wires. There are outer plastic, copper foil, shielding, and plastic insulating layers from outside to inside. So is the coaxial cable. The rest of the colored wires adopt the same design. The other blue wire is composed of copper foil and wound tensile wires. Finally, let's use the Dremel to take apart the connector. Then let's pry along the gap. The metal case is double welded by spot welding, and the junction is firmly fixed. Let's use the spider to open it. There is a circle of magnet used to magnetically connect to iMac. The junction is glued for reinforcement. We can see 12 grooves, which corresponds to 12 contacts we just mentioned. Well, the network transformer is inside the adapter. However, the network interface card and switching circuit are still inside the iMac. and I think we have known how Apple handles the interference. Except for the outer shielding layer and copper foil, every wire has its own shielding layer and copper foil, because stability should always be the priority for wired connections. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to view relative videos. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!